Are you tired of being tired? Do you have no energy, feel exhaust, worn out, weary, and lethargic? Many people who got COVID-19 are feeling this way, and they ask me, will this post-viral fatigue get better? Among my patients with chronic pain, the complaint of fatigue is also very common. They ask me, what is the difference between just being normally tired or this being a symptom of a more serious disease? So, let's talk about chronic fatigue syndrome today. First, let me start by saying that there is a real disorder called chronic fatigue syndrome, or CFS. It is not laziness. The technical name for this disorder is myalgic encephalomyelitis, or ME. So today, when I talk about ME-CFS, I'll be referring to a medical diagnosis of a severe form of fatigue. I have to say that many physicians have never heard of ME-CFS, so they don't even recognize it when they have a patient with this disease. There is no blood test or imaging study that we can order to make the diagnosis of ME-CFS. The diagnosis is based on symptoms and investigations to exclude any other causes for these symptoms. Chronic fatigue syndrome is a chronic disease that affects various systems of the body, mainly the neurological and immunological systems that control many of our body functions and energy level. The main characteristic of this disease is a profound fatigue that does not improve with rest, and may get worse with physical or mental activity. This fatigue that is caused by activity, it's called post-exertional malaise, or PEM. For some people with ME-CFS, exertion can be just brushing their teeth and they will crash. When we suspect of post-exertional malaise, we can order a 2-day cardiopulmonary exercise test, or CPET. It's used to measure anaerobic threshold, which is reduced in post-exertional malaise, or PEM. How does a person get ME-CFS? Well, it's typically following a viral infection or any other type of infection. It starts very sudden. The person will have an initial flu, but the symptoms will persist for a long time. The main symptoms of ME-CFS include fatigue, both physical and mental. Also, they will wake up unrefreshed after a night of sleep. There are also abnormalities in the heart rate. The heart rate can go faster. There is intolerance to a standing position, so the person will always prefer to be lying down in the horizontal position. There is sensitivity to sound, noise, smells, and chemicals. And there is muscle and joint pain. And here is where there is an overlap with fibromyalgia. I have another video that I explain what is central sensitization, which is the underlying cause for both fibromyalgia and ME-CFS. These symptoms vary from day to day, and they are unpredictable. So the person may feel well one day and decide they can do a lot, but the next day they are bedbound and unable to even feed themselves. A high number of people with chronic fatigue syndrome will also have other diagnoses such as fibromyalgia, POTS, mast cell activation syndrome, and autoimmune disorders. 70% of people who have ME-CFS are unable to work. A 2017 Statistics Canada survey revealed that more than 560,000 Canadians report that they have the disease. The Institute of Medicine in the US estimates that there are 1 to 2.5 million Americans with ME-CFS. And I'm afraid to say that many people who acquired COVID-19 may have symptoms of ME-CFS, so these numbers will be even higher in the future. It affects more women than men. It affects people of all socioeconomic backgrounds, all ages, and racial diversity. There are questionnaires that exist that we use to assess the severity of the fatigue symptoms. One of them is the Childer Fatigue Scale, which is used in studies of ME-CFS. There are currently no approved treatments specific for ME-CFS. It is important to remember that not everyone who is chronically tired have ME-CFS. Many people do not meet the criteria for ME-CFS. They may have a medical or psychological condition that explains the tiredness. That's why it's important to exclude any other common condition that causes tiredness, like anemia, heart, kidney, or liver failure, low thyroid function, known as hypothyroidism, sleep diseases, such as sleep apnea, side effects of medications, like blood pressure medications, antidepressants, and opioids, and some psychiatric conditions like depression and anxiety. Second, there are some lifestyles that put a person at a higher risk of being chronically tired. Smoking. Smoking causes poor oxygenation to our body tissues, and oxygen is important to give energy. Watch my other video that I made about smoking. Lack of physical activity. We know that exercise keeps the body and brain healthy and even reduces the risk of dementia. A poor diet that does not offer the nutrients that your body and brain needs may explain why the person is tired all the time. Also, eating very large meals or eating too much sugar leads to fatigue. Sleeping too little or sleeping too much? Watch my other video about sleep hygiene tips. Drinking alcohol in excess and not drinking enough water, which makes the person prone to dehydration. So certainly trying to change these habits may give you a boost in your level of energy. For people with ME-CFS, it's important that they try not to exceed their energy envelope. They should be using an approach that we call pacing and not exceed their limits. If they have severe intolerance to standing up, we call this orthostatic intolerance, we recommend consuming high amounts of salt. Sometimes they even need intravenous saline infusions. In some cases of viral infections, they need antiviral medications. There is some controversy related to recommending exercises for people with ME-CFS because it may make their symptoms worse. It is important to develop a plan for returning to physical activity. I call this the ladder approach, one step at a time. You reach one level, stay there, and keep going up slowly. It's okay to have some drawbacks, but keep your goals on the top of the ladder. We do recommend them to use earphones, earplugs, sunglasses, and eye masks to reduce sensitivity to sound and light, and eliminate all cosmetics, personal soaps, and creams that contain fragrances. Remember the toolbox. I always mention the toolbox to my patients with chronic pain. What are the tools that you have to help you each day? Remember the 5M: movement, mind-body, modalities, manual therapy, and if needed, medications. For patients with ME-CFS, I like to talk about the 6M. Movement includes pacing your physical activity, gentle exercises, gradually increasing the intensity and duration, yoga, tai chi, going for walks, stretching at home, all of these are excellent. Mind-body includes time for yourself, relaxation, meditation, praying, singing, meeting people that you like. It also includes a more structured psychological therapy, such as hypnosis or cognitive behavior therapy. Modalities include applications of heat, cold, a shower, or a bath. Manual therapies include self-massage or going to a massage session or spinal manipulations. The 6M is for meals. It is very important to remember that you are what you eat. Changing your eating habits may seem hard in the beginning, but you don't need to start making drastic changes. Just start by adding some healthy fats to your diet, caffeine in the morning, smoothies, more fruits and vegetables during the day. Remember, your diet starts with your grocery shopping. Take a look at your grocery bill and do a serious analysis of what is healthy and what is not. In summary, Talk to your doctor if your fatigue is lasting longer than 2 weeks. And if you have flu-like symptoms, fever, shortness of breath, loss of appetite, and if you feel exhausted despite sleeping well and eating well. If you are struggling with normal activities that you used to do before, this could be symptoms of a more serious disease. Please don't forget that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is an emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. Below, there is a link to a document that you can download, and it summarizes all the content of this video. If you like this video, give a thumbs up here, turn on the notifications, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. There is a share button here. You can send this video to your friends. I also have many other videos in my channel. Check there for other topics. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Bye!